Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss one of the problem from subsidiary books. You'll find this question on page number 111 and this is the problem number 5. In this question, the questionnaire has asked you to prepare, enter the following transaction in purchase book and purchase return book. In this question, you have to prepare two books. Number one is purchase book. Number two is purchases written book. So the following transaction which is given in the question has to be enter or recorded in purchase book or and purchase written book. The concerned transaction goes to the concerned book. Let us say for example, goods purchased from Jamal. So goods purchased from Jamal comes under purchase book. You have to write in a purchase book. Goods return to Kamal. So this is purchase return. You are returning the goods to the party. So write that transaction, Mr. Kamal name here and the amount. Let's see how to solve this problem. And remember these two points, as you know very well, cash transactions are not going to be recorded either in purchase book or in purchase return book. Only credit transactions are recorded in both the books, purchase book and purchase return book. This question you will find on page number 111. And this is the fifth problem. The question has been given you like this. Enter the following transaction in purchase book and purchase return book. Now you have to prepare two separate books. One book is for purchases. This is called as purchase book. And another book is purchases return book. So all the transactions which is related to purchases are going to be recorded in this book, purchases book. The transactions which is related to purchases returns are going to be recorded in this book. So here there are 5 columns in purchase book: date, particulars, inward invoice number, LF, amount in rupees. Whereas purchases return book also having 5 columns which are date, particulars, debit note number, LF amount. When compared to these two books, look at the third column of these two. Purchases book having the third column inward invoice number and purchases written debit note number. So unless and until it has given you the details about the inward invoice number or debit note number, do not write any number. If it is mentioned in the question, then only you write it. If no inward invoice number or debit note number is given, if no number is given, then do not write anything, just leave it blank. Let's see how to solve this problem. 2018, 1st August, purchase goods from Krishna. Purchase goods from Krishna. On which book you are going to record? On purchases book. 2018, 1st August. So 2018, August 1st, purchase goods from Krishna. Write the party name here, Krishna. And how much is the price? 6,000 rupees. So write the amount here, 6,000 in amount column of purchases book. What is the next transaction means? On date 4th of August 2018, goods purchases from Mallesh, 3,500. So on 4th of August, goods purchases from, write the party name here in the particulars column, Mallesh. How much is the price? 3,500 rupees is the cost of goods purchased from Mallesh. On 8th of August 2018, it has mentioned that in the question, returned goods to Krishna of 600 rupees. The goods what we have bought from Krishna, 6,000 rupees, something happened to the goods. Either we found it defective or damaged or we do not require those goods. So in any case of all these three, sometime you may find damaged goods, sometime destructive goods you will get, sometime the goods you don't want. You got it some more goods, you want to return it. You don't want to use those goods means you are going to return. First of all, you have already purchased the goods from Krishna. On date 8th, you want to return the goods to Krishna. So where you are going to write this return of the goods means, first of all, you have already purchased the goods, now you are returning the goods means purchase return. Already you have purchased, now you are returning means purchases returns. Purchases return transaction is going to be recorded in purchases return book. What is the year? 2018, August 8th. To whom you are returning? Write the party name here, Krishna. How much goods you found defective, damaged or unusable, so you don't want to use those goods, is 600 rupees. Do not write anything in debit note number NLF until and unless it has mentioned in the question that, well, let us say for example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is the debit note number. If it is given in the question, then only you write it. If it is not mentioned debit note number in this, so do not write, just leave it blank as it is. And for the same for LF. Here, what is the next transaction means? On date 13th of August, bought goods from Naveen. Bought in the sense, bought is the past tense of buy. Buy is nothing but purchases. So, purchases goods from Naveen, 2000 rupees, 13th, date 13th. So, you are purchasing here, that is why you are recording the transaction in purchase books, date 13, Naveen. From Naveen, you are buying the goods on 13th of August 2018. What is the price means? 2000 rupees. What is the next transaction? On date 16th of August 2018, goods returned to Mallesh. Already you bought a goods from Mallesh on 4th of August of 3500 rupees. From Mahesh also you got the 3500 rupees, and from him you find, for example, damaged goods, defective goods, you don't want those goods, and the goods which are unable to use. So what you want to return the goods to Mallesh. So first of all, you have already purchased the goods, now you are returning the goods means purchase return. Purchase return. So purchase return goods or the transaction is going to be recorded in purchase return book. So where is the purchase return book? Here. And what is the date? Is 16th of August, you are returning the goods to Mallesh. How much is the price means? 400 rupees goods you want to return to Mallesh. On date 22nd of March, 22nd of August 2018, it has given the details like this, purchase goods from Ravi. So you have purchased the goods, go for the purchases book and write it. What is the date here? On 22nd of August, purchase goods from Ravi. How much is the cost of the goods? Is 4000 rupees. So 4000 is the price of the goods we purchased from Ravi. Question ends here. So what is the total balance of purchases books and what is the total balance of purchase return book means? We'll find here. Do not use calculator at any cost under any circumstances. Board of Intermediate Education does not allow calculator in the examination hall for intermediate students. So go for the total here. 6000, 3000, 9000, 9500, 10500, 11500 plus 4000, 15500 rupees is nothing but total purchases. Total purchases is 15500. What about the total of purchase return book? Total purchases return book. What is the total purchases return book? 600 plus 400 is nothing but 1000 rupees. So in this problem we have to prepare two types of books. One is purchase book, another book is purchase return book. Transactions which are related to purchases are going to be recorded in purchase books. The transaction those are related to purchase return are going to be recorded in purchase return book. Only two transactions, which means we have written the goods to Krishna and Mallesh. Although we have bought the goods from Krishna, Mallesh, Naveen and Ravi, the total purchases is 15,500, whereas total purchase return book is 1,000 rupees. That's all for this question. Hope you understood today's class. We'll continue in the next upcoming classes. Thank you, everyone.